Welcome to another FAR walkthrough video from SuperfastCPA. I'm Logan, and in today's video, we're going to be going over FAR Area 1, and this is Section F. This is an application topic. Calculate solvency ratios, such as the debt-to-equity ratio, the total debt ratio, and the times interest earned ratio. And we're going to be doing that the SuperfastCPA way, which is diving straight into questions to learn the material. If you don't know much about our strategies, make sure you check out our free one-hour webinar training on superfastcpa.com. We teach the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam, which among them is studying the questions first, studying first in the morning, things like that. Those are some of the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam. So make sure you go check out our one-hour webinar to make sure that you know all the other ingredients. And just letting you know, we will only be going over 5 questions in today's video, whereas SuperfastCPA Pro members will have access to the full 10-question video when we post it in the members forum. So if you like this, if you like the webinar, you can get more of the SuperfastCPA training and more of the SuperfastCPA strategies by becoming a SuperfastCPA Pro member. So make sure you look for that after the webinar. And with all that, let's dive straight into the questions. All right, here we are at question 1, and something that we always like to recommend when you're doing questions, especially calculation questions, is reading the last part of the question to know what you're really looking for in this question. So we read this last part first. Based on the information provided, what is the debt to equity ratio for Titan Manufacturing Co? So we know that we need to calculate the debt to equity ratio with all of this information. So some of this information may be irrelevant potentially. Let's read through it. Below are the selected items for the balance sheet of Titan Manufacturing Co. as of December 31st. They add for assets, they add cash, 100K, accounts receivable, 150K, inventory, 200K, property, plant, and equipment, 850K, and accumulated depreciation of $250,000. They had liabilities of accounts payable of 120K, long-term debt, 500K, short-term notes payable, 180K, equity, common stock, 400K, additional paid in capital, 200K, and retained earnings, 300K. So with all this information, again, we need to figure out the debt to equity ratio. Now, just with the name of that ratio, you can probably guess, if you don't already know how this works, that you're focusing on equity and something else, debt. Usually that's the liabilities, right? So it's probably something to do with liabilities and equity. If you know how to do this, you probably have already done it. If you don't know how to do this, that's okay. We're going to go straight to the answer to remember and to learn what the debt to equity ratio is and how to calculate it. So let's go ahead and look at the answer. All right, here we are. The answer is B, 0.89 is the debt to equity ratio. This is a very simple calculation. So as we look at it, you'll probably be like, oh yeah, I know how to do that. Debt to equity ratio, very simply, is total liabilities divided by total equity. It's that easy. So you take all the total liabilities that we saw in this problem, the accounts payable, the long-term debt, the short-term notes payable, add this all up together, and that gets you $800,000 of liabilities. Then you go to the total equity, common stock, additional paid in capital, retained earnings. You add those all up together, that gives you $900,000 of equity. Once you divide $800,000 of total liabilities by the $900,000 of total equity, that gives you 0.88888 technically, but really, if you round that, it's 0.89. So that is the debt to equity ratio for this company. Now, what does the debt to equity ratio mean? It's pretty simple when you think about, again, the name of the ratio. The debt to equity ratio measures how much of a company's financing comes from debt compared to equity. A higher ratio indicates more reliance on debt financing, which can increase financial risk, but may also lead to higher returns if managed well. So it's not necessarily a super bad thing to have a lower debt to equity ratio, like meaning that you have more debt than you have equity. Doesn't have to be bad, but you have to manage it really well. But really what that means is that you're using debt financing more than equity to pay for things. So if you're not managing that well, you could have a lot of financial risk. But overall, that's the idea. Debt to equity, it really is just total liabilities divided by total equity. Very simple ratio. Let's go to the next question. All right, here we are at question 2. Skyline Tech Inc. has total assets. Oh, wait, we should read the last part of the question. Based on this information, calculate the debt to equity ratio for Skyline Tech Inc. Okay, so similar thing, but it's a different question. We still need to calculate the same thing though. So again, back to the top, Skyline Tech Inc. has total assets of $2.5 million as of December 31st. The company also reports liabilities consisting of $600,000 in long-term debt and $300,000 in current liabilities. So with this information, we have to figure out the debt to equity ratio. Now, when you look at this, you might think, they're only giving me assets and liabilities, so how am I supposed to do the debt to equity ratio? But if you remember the accounting equation, then you'll be able to do this. maybe try it yourself. I think that you could figure this out just based off what we talked about in the previous question and your even just your basic knowledge of accounting. Do this problem as best you can. Pause the video. When you're ready, come back. We'll look at it together. All right, here we are. The answer is B again, but it's 0.56 is the debt to equity ratio in this case. Now, again, if you got confused, like how would I even calculate that if I only had assets and liabilities? Well, you just need to remember the accounting equation. And remember, the accounting equation is total assets equals total equity plus total liabilities. So we can flip that around to see what the total equity is. So again, we start with total assets, 2.5 million. We figure out the total liabilities, which was the long-term debt plus the current liabilities. That's 900,000. Now again, assets equals liabilities plus equity. So if we don't know one part of that equation, then we can flip it around. To figure out the total equity, all we have to do is take total assets and subtract total liabilities, and that will give us how much the equity was, because then we know the equity plus the liabilities that we already know, and if we add those together, that equals the assets, so we know that's correct. So the total equity, which is the 2.5 million assets less the $900,000 of liabilities, that equals $1.6 million of equity. Now that we know that, we can do this calculation very easily. Again, debt to equity is total liabilities divided by total equity. So we take this total liabilities that we knew and this total equity that we figured out by taking the liabilities and subtracting them from the assets, and we get a 0.5625, or really just a 0.56 total debt to equity ratio. So again, not too difficult. Debt to equity, it really again is trying to measure how leveraged the company is, or how are they paying for things? Is it through debt, or is it more through equity? It's comparing the two. With a lower ratio, that means that they rely less on debt for the financing, reducing financial risk. While if they have a higher ratio, this indicates greater leverage, and that means potentially higher returns, but also higher financial risk. And we know that about debt. Again, if you don't have all the information, but you have the total assets and then maybe the total liabilities or the total equity, either way, you can figure out the other part of the equation and then do the debt to equity ratio. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward. Let's go to the next question. All right, here we are at question three, kind of a bigger question it looks like, right? But before we do anything, always read the last part. Based on the information provided, what is the total debt ratio for Apex Solutions Inc.? So this is another ratio that we haven't talked about yet. We've only talked about the debt to equity ratio. So let's go up here to the top. Below are the selected accounts from the balance sheet. We have all the assets, we have all the liabilities, we have all the equity. But what comes to your mind when you think of the total debt ratio? Obviously the debt, so we need to know the liabilities because that was how it was in the previous question, but what is it comparing it to now? If you don't know how to do the total debt ratio, that's okay. If you do know how to do it, pause the video, work through all this. I know I didn't read through all of it because it's a lot of information to read and you don't necessarily need all of it to do this calculation. So again, if you know how to do this, pause the video, do the calculation yourself. If you don't know how to do this, that's okay. We're gonna dive straight into the answer to learn how this works. All right, here we are. The answer is B, 0.53. That is the total debt ratio. So now that we know the answer, 0.53, let's go through this explanation a bit more in depth here. Sorry, just trying to get it just right. There we go. So here's the explanation. Total debt ratio, again, very simple. Honestly, the solvency ratios are pretty straightforward. You just take the total liabilities, so still the total liabilities, and then now you're dividing them by total assets. So instead of dividing it by the total equity, you divide it by the total assets. That's the total debt ratio. Again, very straightforward though, once you know what it is. So we have to figure out the total assets. We add up the cash, the accounts receivable, the inventory, the office equipment, the vehicles, and we subtract any accumulated depreciation from what it belongs to. So we subtract this $100,000 of accumulated depreciation for equipment from the office equipment, and we subtract this accumulated depreciation for vehicles from the vehicles. So we add that all up together, as well as, of course, subtracting the accumulated depreciation, and that gives us $990,000 of total assets. And again, it's total assets. You don't even have to worry about, oh, do I include this asset? Do I not include this? It's just total assets. Same with total liabilities. You don't need to question what goes into it. You just need to know how to add it all up together. So accounts payable plus short-term debt plus long-term debt. You add those together. That's $520,000 of total liabilities. So now that we know the total liabilities and the total assets, we can divide the total liabilities by the total assets. And that gives us a 0.525, or really just a rounded 0.53 total debt ratio. Again, Very easy, very similar to the debt to equity ratio. You're just dividing by assets instead of equity. And again, same thing applies where if you don't have the total assets or the total liabilities, but you have at least two parts of the accounting equation, you can figure out whatever you need to figure out. And what does the total debt ratio mean? Pretty easy to think about. The total debt ratio indicates the proportion of a company's assets that are financed by debt. So previously, in the other ratio, we were trying to figure out comparing between equity and debt, like how much is financed from equity compared to the debt. But now we're just seeing how much of our assets are financed by debt. So it's focusing specifically on just the debt. A ratio of about 0.53 means that 53% of Apex Solutions Inc.'s assets are financed through debt. A higher debt ratio suggests more financial leverage, kind of like we've talked about so far, and potential risk, with a lower ratio indicating less reliance on debt financing. That's another one of the ratios, the solvency ratios. Let's go to the next question. All right, here we are at question 4. As always, read the last part of the question. Based on the information provided, calculate the times interest earned ratio for Horizon Enterprises. So a new ratio that we haven't talked about yet in this video. Let's read through this. Below is the income statement for Horizon Enterprises for the year ended. They have the sales revenue, the cost of goods sold, and that obviously gives us the gross profit of $800,000. They have operating expenses listed out here of the salaries, the rent, the depreciation, other operating expenses. That gives us the operating income or earnings before interest and taxes. Oh, that's something that you probably want to pay attention to if you're talking about interest, right? $400,000. Interest expense, $50,000, income tax expense, $70,000. So with all this information, again, we need to figure out the times interest earned ratio. If you've done this before, again, it's not very difficult. Go ahead and pause the video and do the calculation yourself if you haven't already done that. If you don't know how to do this, that's okay. This is a refresher, or you're learning it for the first time. We will go straight to the answer to learn how to do the times interest earned ratio. All right, here we are. The answer is A, 8. 8 is the times interest earned ratio, or the TIE ratio, if you want to call it that. This one is a little bit different than what we were looking at before, but also you just need to know what goes into it. You calculate this by dividing earnings before interest and taxes, or EBIT, by interest expense. Now, if you remember, EBIT is all of the income and expenses that happened before taxes and interest. So EBIT, or operating income, that is the $400,000 in this case. It showed that up here, right here. $400,000, and then there's the interest expense right there of $50,000. So we take the EBIT, divide it by the interest expense, that gives us 8. So again, not too difficult, you just need to know what you're looking for. The times interest earned, or the TIE ratio, helps assess how easily a company can cover its interest expenses using its earnings. A TIE ratio of 8 means Horizon Enterprises earns 8 times what is needed to cover its interest payments, which indicates a strong ability to meet its interest obligations. Now, this is very focused just on interest. It doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to be able to cover other obligations necessarily, but as far as the interest goes, they can cover their interest 8 times, which is great. So the main thing you need to remember with the times interest earned is that it is specifically the income before you've paid your interest expense. That's the income you're dividing by the interest expense so that you know how many times you would have been able to cover that interest expense. That's pretty much the idea there. Let's go to the next question. All right, here we are at question 5. As always, read the last part of the question. Based on the information provided, calculate the times interest earned ratio for Crescent Corp. Okay, we just learned how to do this in the previous question, but let's read through this. Below is selected financial information for Crescent Corp for the year ended. Net income before taxes, $520,000. Net income of $400,000. Interest expense, $80,000. Depreciation expense, $60,000. And income tax expense, $120,000. So again, with that information, kind of different. It's not a full income statement. We have to figure out the times interest earned ratio. Now, if you remember what the times interest earned ratio is, you'll be able to remember, or be able to think through how to get the information you need for the ratio. So pause the video, think through this, think through what you would need to be able to calculate the ratio. You have the information here to be able to do that. When you're ready, come back after doing the calculation and we'll look at it together. All right, here we are at the answer. It is B, 7.5. That is the times interest earned ratio in this case. So let's walk through this. You weren't specifically given EBIT, so you had to figure it out, but it's not too hard to figure out if you remember the order of the income statement. To calculate the times interest earned, or the TIE ratio, we need to add back the interest expense to the net income before taxes to calculate EBIT, or earnings before interest and taxes. So if we don't have EBIT, but we have the net income before taxes, that means that the interest expense has already been taken out of that in net income, but we haven't taken out taxes yet. So all we have to do is add back the interest expense to the net income before taxes, and that will give us the earnings before interest and taxes, because we already have the income before taxes. We just need to also have the income be before interest as well. So now that we've added the interest expense to the net income before taxes, we have the full earnings before interest and taxes, that's $600,000. Then you divide it by 80,000, and that gives you 7.5 for the interest, or the times interest earned ratio. Again, what does that mean? It means that they can cover that $80,000 interest expense 7.5 times with the earnings that they have before they pay that interest expense. So we've talked about three different solvency ratios in this video and a couple different scenarios for some of them. Before we go any further, let's do one more part of the SuperFast CPA process called Pillar Topics. Now, the idea behind Pillar Topics is, as you're going through the questions to learn the material, you will notice the things that keep popping up. The equations or the topics that are obviously important because you've seen two or three questions trying to teach you how to calculate the times interest earned ratio, or you've seen two or three questions trying to teach you how to calculate a specific solvency ratio, you know, different things like that. Whatever you see coming up the most in the questions is most likely what you need to know for test day. So in your own words, you summarize what you learned from those questions as pillar topics so that you are keeping track of the most important things that you learn each day so that you're ready for the exam. Let's go ahead and look at the pillar topics for this video. All right, here we are at the pillar topics. Again, this is kind of just a summary of the most important things that you learned from this video or from the questions that you went over. So let's walk through this. The debt to equity ratio, what does that equal? Total liabilities over total equity. It's pretty easy to remember because debt to equity, or liabilities to equity, it's a pretty easy calculation. Now, what is the point of the debt to equity ratio? It measures a company's financial leverage by comparing its total liabilities to its total equity. It indicates how much debt the company is using to finance its assets relative to its equity, you know, compared to its equity. A higher ratio suggests higher financial risk due to more reliance on debt financing, while a lower ratio indicates less risk with more equity backing. So that's the debt to equity ratio. Now, the total debt ratio, very similar, but instead of dividing total liabilities by total equity, you divide total liabilities by total assets. It shows a similar thing. It shows the proportion of a company's assets financed by debt. So it's not comparing debt to the equity, but it's just showing how much of our assets are financed specifically by debt. It indicates the level of financial leverage in the company. A higher ratio means more of the company's assets are financed through debt, increasing financial risk, while a lower ratio suggests less debt reliance and a stronger equity position. Now let's look at the last ratio we talked about in this video, times interest earned, or the TIE ratio. This is EBIT divided by interest expense. So let's look at this. The times interest earned ratio measures how easily a company can cover its interest expenses with its earnings before interest and taxes. A higher TIE ratio includes a stronger ability to meet interest obligations, reducing the risk of default, while a lower ratio signifies or signals potential difficulty in covering interest payments. So these are the three ratios that we talked about in this video. One last thing that I wanted to kind of throw in here, just as a reminder, you probably already know this, you can probably already think like this, but it's just a good tip for the exam. If you are given total assets, but not both liabilities and equity, or if you're only given total liabilities and total equity, and you need to know the assets, if you have two pieces of the equation, you can still calculate the debt to equity ratio and the total debt ratio by remembering the accounting equation. Because if you have at least two of these pieces, you can figure out the third piece, because total assets equals total liabilities plus total equity. That was just a small tip there at the end, and that is the end of the video. We went over a lot, and if you want to learn more about our strategies, then make sure you go to superfastcpa.com and check out our free 1-hour webinar training. Again, we will teach you the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam, such as going straight to the questions to learn the material, studying in the morning, among other strategies, which will help you to pass the CPA exam without wasting months or even years of your time. Make sure you go check that out. And also remember that if you liked this, if you liked going through these 5 questions with me, remember that SuperFast CPA Pro members will have access to the full 10-question video that we will post in the members forum, so they can get more practice, they can get a little bit more understanding through that 10-question video. So again, if you like this, you can become a Pro member by going to superfastcpa.com, checking out that webinar, or just purchasing our Pro course or our Pro bundle so that you can, again, become a Pro member and get more access to these things. I hope you liked this. I hope this was helpful. If you did like the video, make sure to like it and leave a comment, and I will see you in the next video.